The XR4 is stiff, solid and largely unrelenting. It's a sprinter's dream, and climbs like a Sherpa. When you hit bumps, broken tarmac or potholes, you still feel them as you would on a normal bike, but the following high-frequency vibration, like the resonance of a bell after it spins truck, doesn't happen. Countervail truncates vibrations, and the sort of constant vibrations you feel on a corrugated surface are reduced to individual bumps. The swept forward bar is intended to naturalize your wrist and arm position, but will depend on personal preference. I found it a little more comfortable when climbing, but also recognize the design's rigidity benefits too. The drops are nicely shaped and sprinters will appreciate the lack of bar near their wrists when giving it the bends. Super Wrecker DPS is a luxury. High on rarity value and shift performance, I've always preferred the EPS inner shift lever to its mechanical cousins, and it's a joy to use. The Bora 50 wheels catch a little more wind than shallower rims, but it's not a nasty surprise. The sideways nudge is a little more definite, but even over 30 miles per hour on gusty country lane descents, both rider and wheels remained composed. Braking is pretty good too, not class leading, but well above average, with good initial bite and predictable retardation. With the sort of handling and pace to satisfy a top pro, and a build to satisfy the fattest of wallets, the Ultor XR4 is about as complete a race bike as anyone could wish for. No box is left unticked, and no finish line is safe, but is it worth its price tag? If you have the means, it's going to come down to head versus heart, and the Ultor XR4 certainly has the heart.